Grace and peace to you all, people of God. Truly, we thank God for another day. People of God, I'm coming to you today. The Lord wants some of you to know, you have to realize sometimes why you are suffering and why things are continually repeating in your life. And you hadn't seen the breakthrough. You hadn't seen the promises of God. People of God, sometimes we open up doors in life. And opening up these evil doors will cause you to suffer in life, will cause you not to receive the things of God. And sometimes we have opened doors that we forgot about, or we opened doors that we felt like that there was no evil present. Anytime you open up the door of witchcraft, it doesn't matter what type of witchcraft, there is no good witchcraft. Witchcraft is witchcraft, because sometimes people feel like, well, I went and I had something done, or I did a certain activity, not to harm anybody, to get somebody to love you. There are people that have tapped into witchcraft to get a man or a woman to love them. Hallelujah. And what we do not realize is that when you open the door to the spirit of witchcraft, that marriage, it has not been ordained of God. However, all marriages are honored by God. Hallelujah. But there are some things sometimes that people have tapped into to open up the doors of the enemy. And now a lot of people want God to bless these types of marriages, or want people, they want God to bless these type of businesses and all these types of things. And what God is saying is that I can't bless that in the manner that you want it to be blessed, because the way that you received it. Hallelujah. You didn't receive it on waiting on God. You didn't receive it of trusting God. But there are some people that has moved ahead of God because they was anxious about a thing, and they began to open up evil doors. And so when you open up these evil doors, which sometimes you don't consider it to be evil because you feel like, I didn't do anything to harm anybody. Any door that's opened up to the enemy is evil. It doesn't matter what. Hallelujah. When we go and start tapping into other spirits, to the unknown spirit, it is against God. And so the Lord is letting us know that, you know, you're waiting on God to do some things. And the reason he can't move the way he wants to move is because of the doors that you have opened. Many of you have to repent of the doors that you open and the sin that you have created for your own life. And now you got to pray that God give you grace to go through it. Why? Because God said, my word is true. Hallelujah. What a man soweth, that shall a man also reap. Hallelujah. Some of you have worked some things against people. Hallelujah. In the form of witchcraft to try to harm people. And these things have not taken place because, see, sometimes you don't know the one that you're working this stuff against. And if it's a man or a woman of God, it shall not work. No weapon forming against them is going to prosper. And so now you see that it did not work. And now you want to come with what you're trying to say is a heart of repentance. You're going to reap what you sow. That's why God has been crying out loud, letting his people know to turn from these wicked ways, turn from these evil elements that you've been using. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So there are some of you, you're waiting on God to move, and you're waiting on some things to happen in your life. But God said you have to repent of your evil ways, your evil doings. You know what you did. Hallelujah. And we try to justify. We'll justify that we went to somebody and they say, oh, you can perform this and you can perform that. And it's not evil. It's not wicked. Let me tell you something. Any kind of enchantment you did, any kind of writing down people's names you did, any kind of hole that you dig a hole and put their name in, any kind of putting their name in the freezer and freezing, all this stuff is witchcraft. All this stuff is against God. And so when you open up the doors to the enemy, now you have caused yourself to be in a place that now the enemy knows that you went against God, and he knows that God's word is true. So I encourage you to repent of your evil ways. Quit acting like you didn't do it. Quit acting like nobody knows. People may not know, but God knows. It's time to repent, people of God. Witchcraft is real and it's against God. Hallelujah. God doesn't honor that at all. I don't care. Even the people who operate in witchcraft to get business, and their businesses are actually hallelujah, are successful, but woe be unto them. That's why God tells the body of Christ, I don't want you to gain this whole world and lose your soul, because there are many looking like they're, they're actually prospering in the workforce because they tapped into a source of witchcraft, my God, to gain wealth. Woe be unto them. But as the body of Christ, Jesus said, I don't want you to gain this whole world and lose your soul. I want you to do it according to my word. Hallelujah. Seeking the face of God, seeking the instructions of Jesus Christ, doing his will wholeheartedly. So I encourage you today, those of you that has opened up evil doors, hallelujah, you need to repent. You need to repent and you need to turn from that. Hallelujah. You need to pray and ask God to give you the grace to go through what you're going to have to go through, because his word has already been spoken. God said, my word is not going to return back to me void. I said it. And because I said it, it is going to come to pass. So I encourage you today, people of God, it's time to repent. And it's time to have a true heart in repentance, that you are sorrowful for what you have done. So I encourage you this day to do what thus saith the Lord. Be encouraged.